Welcome to Excel Campus. My name is John, and in this video, I'm going to explain how to copy VBA code into your own Excel workbooks. So we're going to look at four different ways to do this. And the first way is just the regular old copy and paste method. So if we are on, let's say we find some code on a web or maybe download another workbook that contains some code, we want to bring that into our own workbook. Here's an Excel Campus page with some VBA code or a macro to clear all filters. So we're just going to copy this text here, Control C or right click copy. And then I'm going to jump back over to Excel. We'll jump into the VB editor. So developer tab, Visual Basic button, keyboard shortcut is Alt F11. And then here we are in this book, just book one is the book we want to add the code to. We need to first insert a code module. So we'll go to the insert menu here and choose module. Keyboard shortcut is Alt IM. Now we'll add a new module here, module one in the module one or in the modules folder. And we can just double click to open that if it doesn't automatically open. And right here we can hit Control V or right click paste to paste our macro. Now, once we have VBA code in this workbook, when we attempt to save the workbook, whether we click the save button here in the VB editor, or we go back to Excel and click save, we're going to get this warning message here, just letting us know that this workbook has VBA code in it. We can continue saving as a macro free workbook, which we do not want to do. So we're going to click no here, and then this will prompt us to save the file. We'll just put it in a folder here. And the most important thing is we want to change the save as type to a .xlsm extension, a macro enabled workbook. These workbooks can contain macros. We'll see the extension changes there, and we'll just click save, and then that will save the workbook and save our VBA code in that workbook. So the second way to add VBA code to our workbook is just regular old drag and drop in the VB editor. So we'll go back over to the VB editor here, and then here in this workbook here, in this project, I have a code module, this one here, MTOC, and within this code module, I have a macro for that creates a table of contents, and then there's another function at the very bottom of this for checking if sheets exist. So if I wanted to add all of this code to my workbook, another very simple way to do this is to just go over here and left click and hold the module right here within the Project Explorer window, and then we can drag this to other workbooks. So I can drag it up here to book one. Once book one is highlighted, I can release the left mouse button, and that will actually make a copy of the entire module and import it right here into the modules folder in that workbook. It does not move it. If we go back down to that file, that module still exists in the original workbook here, or the original file. It's just making a duplicate copy and importing it into whichever workbook we drag it into. And we can also do this if we want to move modules into our personal macro workbook. It works the same way. I can just left click and hold, drag this into my personal macro workbook here until that lights up. Then I'll release that, and then that will be placed in my modules folder here. We can see it right down here is our table of contents module. And then same thing there. If you drag a module into a file that's not a macro enabled workbook, you'll need to also save it as a macro enabled workbook with that .xlsm extension. Now, if you accidentally drag a module into a workbook and you didn't want to do that, you can always remove it. Just right-click on the module and choose Remove, and then the module name here in the right-click menu. And that will bring up this prompt here. It says, do you want to export it before removing it? In this case, we'll say no, and that will just remove or delete the module from that workbook. Now, this drag and drop method also works with user forms and class modules. So here in my list search add-in, I have a user form here, and this is the user form preview over here with all the controls, but this will also work with user forms. So if we want to drag this user form into another file, we can use that same drag and drop technique to drag it into another file. And that also works with class modules as well. Now, that technique does not work with sheet objects. So if you have code in sheet objects, and I have an example of that down here on this table of contents auto update file. I have this sheet object right here. If we double click this, we can see there's code in this sheet object for the worksheet activate event, and then some other macros here. Unfortunately, we can't just drag and drop this into other files. So in this case here, we would need to open this Excel file. Just go ahead and open it here. And then we would copy this sheet. This is the sheet here that again contains that code. We just right click, move or copy. And then of course we can create a copy, select our destination workbook. We'll just put it in book one here and click OK. And that will of course move that tab or that sheet into that workbook. If we jump back into the VB editor here and we'll go look at that workbook, it's right now right here in book one. We double click it. We can see the code has traveled with that as well. And then the last way to copy VBA code is to export and import the modules. So we'll jump back down here to our TOC module. And if we right click this here, we'll see this option to export the file. We can actually export this code module. Just click that. That'll prompt us here to export and save the file. These are called basic files. They have a .bas extension. We can just save it to any folder on the computer. You can see I already have this saved right here. But if you click the save button, of course, that'll just warn me, ask me if I want to replace it. I'll say yes, and that's fine. And then we can also import this into any existing file. So if we go back up to book one here, we can just right click book one, choose import file, and here will be that file that we want to import. So we'll just select that there, click open, and that will import the code module here into our file. So this is great if you want to send your code to your coworkers or other people without sending them the entire file. You can just export the code module and then they can import it into their files or even their personal macro workbook. So there are four different ways to copy VBA code into your workbooks. I hope that helps you out. Of course, if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. If you enjoyed that video, there are a few simple things you can do to help me out. If you're watching this video on YouTube, click the like button below the video and leave a comment with any questions or feedback. And please don't forget to subscribe to my free email newsletter to get more tips and tricks that will help you learn Excel. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.